That of vast numbers of fields all around us. After the overnight journey, some of us called in at one of the local shops in the village, which seemed to have a stock that was years old, as many of the Mars bars were turning mouldy on the shelf. Glad to say our provisions did not come from this grocer.
This morning gave us a chance to practice the washing up. Notice the clean water used. Everyone gives a hand at this job, yet. To show we had really been to the summit, we built a pile of rocks around one of our members with what energy we had left. It was an impressive sight from the top, all the fields different shapes and colours, and far below a miniature looking campsite. As you can see, we were only dressed in our camp gear, as the hill was only hundreds of yards from the camp.
On the third morning, we were to put into practice what we had worked. Everyone was very Eventually, however, we reached the top, exhausted, and looked at the breathtaking view, looking northwest across the Lake District. The descent was not so difficult, but one had to be careful of loose rocks falling on other members of the party.
Compulsory morning wash. These shots are the rarest sights you'll ever see. The stream was icy cold, but is ideal to camp near. We were also lucky to have our own swimming pool.
Every morning the flag was saluted, and each day an inspection took place to check that scouts had washed behind their ears, and that we had the right gear available for that particular day's activity. Today, it was planned that we would leave the base camp in groups of three and four and find a site and place of interest to camp on our own. The National Parks Warden of the area paid the troop a visit, which enabled us to discuss with him routes and suitable camping sites. We found his friendliness, advice and knowledge of the area most interesting and very useful. Thank you. Camping out in small groups is an essential part of scout training.
The Open Scout Caving Centre. This centre is one of many opened up over Britain for scouts to take part and learn new skills in all of the many outdoor sports. After a lecture in the comfort of the centre's luxurious common room, we were kitted out with the essential equipment. Skip had told us we would need warm clothing, so after testing our lamps and equipment, the two parties set off for the caves.
This was to be a day back to semi-civilization, to visit the small town of Settle. The camp bank was open, as this was to be an opportunity to purchase all the goodies in the town. Too soon for many of us, the day to a pack up arrived, and after a filling breakfast of bacon and eggs, we started the job of taking the tents down and packing 3 tons of camping equipment into the vans. At the same time, we thought of the things we had done during the past week.
Crawling through the tunnel of mud down the cave, gives me the creeps.
And the fight we had climbing up the waterfall whilst in the caves.
On the first day, having to move our tent after placing it over a stream outlet.
And by the end of the week, Brian's trousers had come to grief, and he was only left with one pair of dirty PE shorts.
Then there was Andrew, who lost his radio.
Leaving our village friends and newly acquired enemies to return to their peaceful, dreamy existence.